Welcome to our demo on how to simplify the way you access and manage your private RDS databases using Border0. RDS is one of the most popular databases out there, and many folks deploy RDS in a private VPC, which makes sense for security purposes, but makes it challenging to access the database for routine engineering tasks or troubleshooting. So in this demo, we'll look at how to solve that without the need for VPNs or bastion hosts or other clunky tools. And while we're at it, we will also solve the problem of shared credentials and access management. When it comes to accessing private RDS databases securely, there are two main challenges. First off, network access, and second, shared database credentials. So regarding to network access, so these private VPCs provide security because they're isolated, right? They're in an isolated VPC and only those in the VPC can access it. But that makes it difficult for engineers and administrators that need to access the database for everyday tasks or troubleshooting. So the second problem is the challenge of shared credentials. It's still very common, and in fact, the RDS default to provide static credentials that you then often share with your team. And then everybody will use those same credentials to log in. So now it has a few challenges. First off, rotation of these secrets, figuring out who has access to these credentials. And last but not least, granular access rules based on identity, as well as auditability and accountability. So having these shared credentials makes it really tough to determine who has access and what are they doing, what queries are being executed. So this is where Border0 comes in. It addresses these challenges by simplifying access to the private databases without the need for a VPN, eliminating shared credentials, and allowing users to log in with their existing single sign-on credentials. Additionally, we'll also allow you to control who has access using policies and under what conditions. And we'll provide complete visibility into who accessed your databases, including what identity, from where, when, and what queries were being executed while they were in your database. Take a quick look at a demo. This is a EC2 machine that happens to be in the same VPC as the private RDS instance. This is also the private VPC. This machine only has egress access. That's okay. As long as it can go out through the NAT gateway, that's sufficient. So to take a look at what this looks like, first of all, you need a configuration file for the Border0 connector. And there's a few lines in here that are of interest. Obviously, you need a token. This is the Border0 token. You can get that through the API or through the portal. And then you can create what we call sockets or services. And this is the first one. In this case, we only have one service. This is the name that I gave it, DB Border0 Static Credentials. And so first off, we need to define the database that we want to make available. So this is the database, the RDS instance, port 3306, so the standard MySQL port. It's of type MySQL. And then in the last two lines, these are the database credentials that the connector will use to connect to the database. And finally, take a look at this line. This is the policy. So in this case, we're attaching one policy, and we'll take a look at that in a bit to define who has access to this service. Then we want to start the connector. I already have it running, but this is basically what you do. Border0 connector start, and then the configuration file, and that's the configuration file we just looked at. So now we should be ready to connect to it. So I'll open a different window here, and I'm going to log in, Border0 client login, and I'm going to log into the organization that I want to log into. So I'm being asked to authenticate, so I will authenticate with my Border0 credentials. Okay, so I should be logged in now. So now let's take a look, Border0 client. Let's take a look at all the databases I have access to. So we see this first one. There's two other ones. We'll take a look at those in a bit. But this was the first one. I know the database schema is Border0. It's a test database. And this is where I get to choose which client I'd like to connect with. In this case, we'll use MySQL, the CLI client. So boom, I'm already connected. It's pretty fast. So we can do show tables. We see books. Let's do describe books. Take a look what that looks like. And then we can do something like select star from books. And there you go. So that worked great. Before we continue, I want to look at two more examples of how you can configure a database in the connector configuration file. The first thing I want to highlight is support for SSM, so Amazon's parameter store where you can store secrets. So you can replace any of the static secrets that we had before, like here, for example, we had a password, with something like AWS: SSM: and then the path to wherever the secrets live. So in this case, you can see I used it for host. I'm using it for upstream user as well as upstream password, as well as the token. You can see I've replaced that with this. So just make sure you have the right role attached to your EC2 instance or container, and we can fetch these secrets for you. That's all built into the Border0 connector. And then thirdly, we have this example, and here we're using RDS IAM credentials. So again, there's another way to talk or to connect to RDS. If you use this flag, RDS IAM authentication, and you've set up your RDS to work with IAM authentication, then we can integrate with that as well. You can find more documentation and details for that on both the AWS website as well as the Border0 docs.border0.com website. But the point here is that we've set up basically three services, either using vanilla static credentials or using SSM integration or using the RDS IAM integration. Whatever is needed, we can help you support it. All right, finally, let's take a look at what that looked like from the admin perspective. So this is the Border0 portal. These are the details for this socket. So first I will click on sessions, and this should show me all the sessions that went through this. And you can see how I logged in, exactly what time, from which IP, etc. You can see it was Andre at Border0 who logged in with his credentials. You can then click on replay session, and then I can see exactly what queries were being executed. So if you remember, we started using Border0, show databases, show tables, describe books, and select star from books is the exact query that we executed. So you can now see that and literally replay it. We briefly talked about policies as well, so let's take a quick look. This is the screen where I can see what policies are attached. This was the one that we attached, the demo RDS policy. So here you can see how we can define who has access to this service, under what conditions, so where does this user need to come from, which IP addresses, which countries, etc., and between what dates or what time of day. So we can just edit that using the editor or the JSON view. In this demo, we saw how Border0 makes it really easy to manage and provide access to databases, even if your database sits in a private network, such as a private VPC. We saw how it's really easy for end users, such as engineers and database administrators, to discover what databases they have access to and to connect to these databases using the tools they already use, so their existing workflow. And they can just use their existing SSO single sign-on credentials. So no more need for shared credentials that you have to share with the whole team. We also went through what is needed to set this up with Border0. And as you could see, it was really easy using the Border0 connector. And you saw that we provided you various ways to have the connector connect to the database, either using static credentials or using integration with AWS SSM or AWS IAM and RDS integration. Finally, we saw how, as an administrator, you can manage policies to define who has access to these databases under what conditions. And we saw all the database sessions were being logged, and we could then see all the queries that were being executed by each individual. So giving you lots of visibility and control. Finally, we encourage you to experience the benefits of Border0 for yourself. You can sign up at this URL and try out the free, fully functional Community Edition.